Good afternoon and welcome to the 1:30 p.m. news. I am Jonathan Lim. Erik Paulsen's remand enters its second day today. The Center for Independent Journalism, or CIJ, has expressed alarm that the Sedition Act is being used arbitrarily to stifle freedom of speech. In a statement, the CIJ also called for the immediate release of Paulsen, who is a Lawyers for Liberty co-founder. Paulsen had reportedly published a tweet calling on the government to take extremism seriously and accusing the Malaysian Islamic Development Department, JAKIM, of promoting extremism through its Friday sermons. The tweet was subsequently removed. He was remanded on Monday night. There have been crescendo of criticism against the remand and the use of the Sedition Act since Monday. Now on to something else. A straw poll conducted by Rakyat Times' Selina Tay reveals a shocking truth. A random survey among bank employees shows that many of them are unsure as to what 1MDB is about. Answers range from "I don't know" to "a government project" to "a government fund." A majority of the respondents, when asked if they knew how the sovereign fund operated, replied that it was too complicated. A shocking revelation indeed, especially since it involves a colossal amount of money that could send the country belly up. And in France, satirical weekly Charlie Hebdo drew ire yesterday with another cover image. In defiance of the militants who had killed 12 people in an attack on its Paris office, the new edition satirizes Islam again. Last week's murderous attack drew global condemnation, including that from several Islamic bodies. However, the new cover quickly raised concerns that it would stir hatred between communities. And that was the 1:30 p.m. news on Rakyat Times TV. We will be back again tomorrow.